Hi, you guys. I'm Phil Town from Rule One Investing. Today, I want to tell you about major stock market crashes throughout history and what we can learn from them. Hey, before we get started, make sure you click on the subscribe button and the bell icon to get notifications when I release new videos, okay? You probably heard before that those who do not learn from history are doomed to repeat it. And this saying holds true for many things, including investing. Past stock market crashes provide a really amazingly unique window into what causes the stock market to crash, helping us kind of, you know, take a prediction of sorts when the next crash might take place. So let's take a look at some of the most famous market crashes throughout history and what we can learn from them. The first one we can talk about, actually, we can go way back if we want to. Stock market started right around 1600, and stock market crashes began almost immediately thereafter. They've had stock market crashes around all sorts of things, including investments in, shipping to South America, shipping to India, doing tulips. But the most famous one, of course, happened in the 20th century, I believe, last century. Called Black Tuesday 1929. The Black Tuesday stock market crash that took place in 1929, that remains the worst crash in U.S. history. Over a four-day period, the Dow Jones Industrial Average dropped 25%. And this is the crash that kicked off the Great Depression in the United States. Now, it wouldn't have been so bad if it was just 25%. That's kind of, by definition, just a recession. But the market continued to crumble. And it continued to crumble for many, many, many months and ultimately lost over 90% of its value. Experts agree the cause of this crash was largely due to over-optimistic investors. Just a few years prior to the crash, margin investing was invented. This allows investors to borrow money to buy stocks. And that ability, the newfound money that came with it, combined with a very strong bull market, led most everybody to invest without any caution at all, thinking it can only go up. And that caused the market to rise about 20% a year from 1922 to 1929. And when signs of this market drop started showing, like a bear market, which is the opposite of a bull market, starting to be a bad market, when the signs of this bear market started showing, people got really scared because they were leveraged, right? And they needed to get out or they would owe their houses. And the panic that followed that was incredibly swift and it was devastating. The danger of over-optimism in a bull market is the primary lesson that can be learned from the Black Tuesday crash. But another really important lesson is that if you have capital available to you after a market crash, you can get seriously rich. This is exactly what happened with Ben Graham. This is why he wrote the book Security Analysis in 1934, because he discovered that having available capital when you can buy companies for pennies on the dollar is the single best way to get rich with very low risk. The second big crash was Black Monday 1987. Now, this came right in the beginning of an amazing long bull market run. In October 19th, 1987, the Dow dumped 22% in a single day, and that ended 5 years of straight up. It was a drop that absolutely came out of nowhere. Experts are still trying to figure out what happened. A lot of them disagree about what happened, what caused that crash. There were some seriously ominous signs such as slowing economic growth, rising inflation, but there was really nothing in the economic climate that would have predicted such a sudden and significant drop. Surprisingly, the crash only lasted one day and the market soon climbed back to its highs. Now, the reason I'm bringing up this really sort of sudden crash and recovery is that it teaches us something very important about the market. The stock market is fickle. It is emotionally driven. This is so different than what they teach in college about the modern portfolio theory and how the market's always rational. The Black Monday crash teaches us that the market can be anything but rational. It can be panicked. And sometimes what that means is it's impossible to predict what can happen out there, which is why it's so important that we don't buy the market It's really important we buy wonderful businesses with the idea that if the market shut down tomorrow, the business that you own is so wonderful that you wouldn't care. It would just any more than you would care, if the market shut down and you own a private business, it's not even in the public stock market. So it's really important to understand we buy businesses, not the market. And it also teaches one really optimistic lesson as well. The market will recover very quickly from even an extraordinarily dramatic crash. And this is really true. The stock market, even in the 1930s, recovered extraordinarily quickly. By the time FDR got elected president, the stock market was already recovering from its bottom. And had they not tightened up money supply in 1938, I think we would have probably come out of the depression right then. If you're worried about stock market crashes, odds are you need to learn a little bit more about how to invest. I've got a free investing course where you can learn that crashes don't matter as much as you think. Just click on the screen to check it out and get a little education here. Might be a good time, particularly because we're coming up on a really interesting time in the stock market. Now, let's talk about the tech bubble crash that happened in 1999. 1990s, this was a period of rapid technological development, the commercialization of the internet, and that caused valuations of internet-based companies to just rise right off the roof. Investors got so excited about the potential of investing in the next big thing that they were throwing their money into any company that had a .com after it. They weren't even thinking about what's the business. But these were lessons they started to get very, very soon, that a lot of these companies were doomed to fail. And even the ones that succeeded, it was idiotic to pay for them what people were paying in 1999. You ready for this? People were paying so much in 1999, they were buying Yahoo at a 20,000 PE ratio, which meant that within 10 years, Yahoo would have to take over the entire GDP of the United States in order to be worth that kind of money. It was absolutely insane. Another indication that the market can be anything but rational. In March of 2000, large companies started placing sell orders on their tech stocks. And that started a panic that led to a 10% drop in the market within a few weeks. By 2001, the majority of the new tech companies, no longer being propped up by investor money, disappeared from existence, gone, causing hundreds of millions of dollars, billions of dollars of investors' money to go to zero. Here's the lesson: the importance of carefully evaluating your companies that you're going to own, no matter how trending they might be, is a primary lesson we can learn from the tech bubble crash. Had investors taken more time to assess the fundamentals, the management, the moat, the other factors that we look at, cash flow, rather than just blindly hoping they were going to just be in the next big thing, much of the pain of the tech bubble bursting could have been avoided. But that isn't how the market works. It's going to create opportunities for you and me because that isn't how the market works. There's one more that we've had in our little lifetimes. This is the one you probably remember, the housing market collapse of 2008. Over the course of that process of the financial system starting to melt down, the Dow fell almost 34%. And it wasn't until early 2009 that it began to climb up again after losing something in the ballpark of 50%. That was really intense. And by the way, you might remember that I got out of the market in late 2007 because I just thought things were too overvalued. And I started getting back in right when many of you were starting to get out. Obviously, the exact reason for a crash is extremely complex and nobody really knows for sure. What we do know is, though, that financial institutions at the federal government level, financial institutions like Fannie Mae, Freddie Mac, were buying a lot of what turned out to be really bad loans. And that driving market made people feel wealthy. And as a result of that, the stock market had recovered from its drop in 2000, 2001, 2002, and started to rise to new levels that we hadn't seen before ever. So once real estate prices began to drop, people started to feel nervous about their assets. They started to pull money out of the market. Boom, we end up in another gigantic crash. So what's the lesson we want to learn here? You know, should we learn a lesson that says that, oh, watch out for the housing market, or watch out for the macroeconomics, or watch out for what's going on in the global world? And the truth of the matter is, Warren Buffett once said that if they came in and told him what the interest rates were going to be a year from now, it wouldn't change one iota of how he's investing his money. And that's how we should think about it as well. We shouldn't be worried about you know, the collapse of some kind of economic system. We've got our money in the stock market. What we should be concerned about is, do I own wonderful businesses and did I buy them at wonderful prices? And if we're in the stock market the next time it goes down, well, hey, when it's starting to rain gold, you know, you go out there with a washtub, right? Get the money out from something else, borrow money against your house, whatever you got to do, and load up the truck with these high quality companies that are then on sale. Or even better, if you can see that you're getting companies that you bought years ago, and now their prices have risen to a place where they're way more pricey than they should be, their price is well above their value, this might be a time to take some money off the table and prepare to create that great big washtub you're going to want to have in a couple of years. So here's the deal. High quality, wonderful businesses are going to survive the crash. They're going to survive the tide going out. In fact, they're going to come out of it better than ever, because when the tide goes out, we get to see who's swimming naked. And some of those companies are competing against other companies that are going to fail in that tight economic environment. And that's going to benefit you and me, the owners of the great companies. So I'd love to hear from you guys. Is the fear of a market crash keeping you from investing? And if it is, what would you need to know in order to be comfortable right now leaving your money in cash? Because it's scary either way, right? So leave a comment below with your answer and I'll be sure to follow up with you. And thanks for watching, you guys. Now go play. If you enjoyed this video and you feel it was valuable in teaching you more about stock market crashes, hit the like button and please share this video with your friends. And if you want more investing content, subscribe to my channel. And don't forget to click the button on the screen for a free gift. So thanks for watching.